In this video, we're going to cover a quick overview of the shapes and polygon tools in Scribus, how to add shapes to your document canvas, how to select different shapes, and how to edit polygons to create unique shapes to add to your document canvas as well. So let's get started.
Welcome to class.
Let's start by running Scribus. For this video, we'll be using the default document template. So when the new document wizard appears, we'll leave the defaults and select OK. Adding shapes. Let's start by taking a look at how to add shapes to our document canvas. One way to add a shape is from the standard menu. We can select Insert and then Shape. Selecting Shape reveals an additional submenu that allows you to select the type of shape you want to insert based on various categories such as default shapes or arrows. Each of the shape categories are relatively self-explanatory. The default shapes category contains shapes such as rectangles, circles, and triangles. The arrows category contains various shapes of arrows. And the jigsaw category contains a number of shapes that look like puzzle pieces. From the standard menu, let's select Insert, Shape, and then Default Shapes, and then select Rectangle. Notice how the mouse icon changes to indicate that the shape has been selected. Now let's add it to the document by using our computer mouse and left-clicking on the canvas. This will add the shape to the document with the shape's default dimensions. Another means of adding shapes to the document canvas is by using the shortcut ribbon. By left-clicking on the shape icon, your computer mouse will once again change, indicating that you can add the selected shape to the document. Looking closely at the shape icon and the shortcut ribbon, you should notice a small arrow pointing downward. This arrow indicates that by holding the left mouse button down when clicking on the icon, you can access additional selections. Let's give it a try. Again, we will left-click and hold the mouse button down for a few seconds until the Additional Selection menu appears. Notice after the selection that the shortcut ribbon changes, indicating that future shapes using the shortcut ribbon will use the indicated shape. And the mouse icon changes, indicating that the shape is ready to be added to the document canvas. So let's click on the canvas and add it. Once you have a shape selected, this will be indicated by the shape displayed in the shortcut ribbon. You can also use the keyboard shortcut S to add shapes to your document as well. Let's go ahead and add a few shapes. Creating polygons. After looking through the list of available shapes, I just can't seem to find the shape I'm looking for. But it's not the end of the world. Scribus has a polygon tool that can help us out. So let's talk about creating polygons. The polygon tool allows you to create additional and even unique shapes. A feature of the polygon tool is its polygon properties panel that can be used to define and generate shapes. You can open the Properties panel from the standard menu by selecting Insert, Polygon, and then Properties, or by left-clicking on the polygon icon in the shortcut ribbon until you see the Properties option appear, followed by selecting Properties. With the Polygon Properties panel open, you should see a number of settings along with a preview window. In addition to being able to set the shape's number of corners and rotation, you can also apply a factor, an inner rotation, along with an inner and outer curvature. Some of these properties are somewhat self-explanatory. Inner rotation adjusts the rotation of the polygon based on its inner points, whereas increasing the inner and outer curvature makes the polygon's points more curved and smooth. The factor property could use a little more clarification, though. By applying a positive factor to the polygon, the shape begins to expand or explode with additional points, However, if a negative value is used, the polygon begins to restrict or implode. Like shapes, once you're done with making adjustments in the Polygon Properties panel, select OK. And as with other elements, you should see the computer mouse icon change, indicating that you can now add the polygon to the document canvas. With your computer mouse, go ahead and click on the canvas to add your polygon. In this video, we discussed the shapes and polygon tools in Scribus. We reviewed various methods of selecting and adding different shapes to our document. And we discussed how to create and add unique shapes using the polygon tool. If this video helped you, or you would like us to cover a specific topic regarding the shapes or polygon tools in Scribus, be sure to let us know in the comments section. See you in the next one.